Hello friends, today we will study pragmatism. So pragmatism is also called Prayojanvad in Hindi. Today I will present this video in English medium, then I will present in Hindi too. So first we study through English medium. Okay, so let us start. What is pragmatism? The term pragmatism has been derived from Greek word pragma. Okay, so this is Greek word pragma, which means activity or practice or action. So pragmatism is related with activity, practice or action. So, an action gets priority over thought. What you thought, do it in action. Pragmatism is known as expenditure, not it is experiment. I have corrected, but so it is experiment or experience. Experiment or experience. Let me write again. So it is experiment or experience. Okay. So as action gets priority over thought, when you stop thinking and start working, that is known as experiment or experience. So pragmatism is known as experiment, not expenditure. So please correct it. Which based in practicability or utility, depending upon the truth, reality, goodness or badness, which are all relative terms and are not predetermined absolute. When you start doing experiment or working, so its practicability or utility depends upon the truth. Reality, truth and reality, you don't know. When you start doing anything, any experiment, you are not knowing whether it is going to be good or bad, whatever it will be. So it is not predetermined. It comes after doing experiment. So pragmatism tends to hold the idea that the truth or fact of study, whatever happened, whatever was true yesterday needs to be experienced truly today or tomorrow. It may change. It idealizes the activity on the basis of its consequences over time frame. What does it mean? Okay, whatever you do, whatever you have learned, it goes on changing. It does not remain the same for the time immemorial. So all the time it is not true, it changes. So pragmatism stresses on experimentation and experience. So in short, it conceptualizes an inference on the basis of changed or changing needs, circumstances and places. So whatever was true yesterday may not be true today, or may not be applicable today, or may not be useful today, because our need has changed, circumstances have changed, places have changed. So you know, you have seen pager, and what happened? Pager has gone. Landline is also in most of the places, landline phones are not there, basic phones are not there, but the mobile phones and cell phones have taken their places. So pragmatists believe that no truth is absolute or permanent. So what pragmatists believe, that nothing is permanent or absolute. It is even changing from time to time and place to place and from circumstances to circumstances. What does it mean? What was true for one time, one place or one circumstances may not be true truth at present also. So the fundamental start of pragmatism is change. So it lays emphasis on change. So what is changing? Is creating something new, experimenting. What you know was true yesterday need not to be true today. The philosophy of pragmatics is predetermined to those ideas and values which suggest in utility to mankind in certain time, place and circumstances rather than any predetermined of life. So what they believe that whatever ideas or values were useful for mankind at one time, it was useful for that time being because that circumstances or that places it was useful, but it is not the permanent solution for or it will not continue till time continue to time immemorial. So it will not continue for future also. There must be some change. Okay. So being practical and utilitarian school of philosophy, utilitarian means believes in utility. So practical and utilitarian school of philosophy, pragmatism has influenced education to the maximum extent. It has influenced the education maximum. It has tried to overcome the limitations of other schools. What the schools were, the schools of thought were there, whether it was idealism, it was naturalism. So their thought was not utilitarian or practical like pragmatism. So it had influenced the world to a great extent. The chief exponents of pragmatism are C.B. Peirce, R.G. Baum, John Dewey, Dewey is very famous, William James, Will Durant, and Schiller. Kilpatrick's name is also there. For pragmatism, experience is at the center of the universe. So, what it stresses on experience, on experiments, since it lays emphasis upon man-made ideas and values created by experimental methods. So, you know, experimental method is authentic. You do experiment and get the result. So, pragmatism is based on experimental methods. So, it is very practical and useful for mankind. Pragmatism, what is pragmatism? In short, it's an educational philosophy that says education should be teaching students the things that are practical for life and encourage them to grow into better people. So what are required for practical life or that which are practical for life, and it encourages the students to grow into better people. So many educators, John Dewey, William James, were pragmatists. As I have mentioned the names earlier, they are also pragmatists. Okay. Aim of education in pragmatism. What are the aims? Education should aim at continuous reconstruction and reorganization of experiences. What it says? It says that we should not carry the old ideas and old experiences. So we have to reconstruct them, reorganize them. Second one is development of activity and experience-based learning. So learning will be long-lasting. Or when it is based on activity or experience-based, so learning will be long-lasting and more understandable for the children to develop social efficiency, harmonious development of individual, of mankind, or own development, so that he can adjust with all, he can adjust in or adapt all environments. Education perceived through activity and experience. What it says is education to be perceived through action and experience and experiment, creation of new values and continuous growth. These are the aims of education in pragmatism. So what we will elaborate? The aims of education. So first aim is to create new values. So pragmatism do not believe in the theory of any fixed aim of education. In their opinion, aim of education is to create new values and act of teacher is to help himself to develop new values. Okay, so every time they have to develop new things. So that is pragmatism. To enable students to gather experience through activity, they have to learn. Students will learn through activity. New values and experiences are essential. Education should therefore provide physical, intellectual, moral, aesthetic and activities as media for the creation of new values. So how do you create new values? Through the medium of medium through physical, intellectual, moral and aesthetic activities. So they have to do physical activities also. They have to solve puzzles. They have to learn things. So intellectual activities, moral values. Moral activities to help improve. So moral activities will help to inculcate the social skills and aesthetic activities. It will make them to learn to appreciate the things and preserve the beautiful things, beautiful nature, to help the people to adjust with them and with him and society. Other important of education, according to pragmatism, is to help people to make adjustment with himself and the society. So first he has to make adjustment with himself. Then with the society. To help the people to reconstruct his experience. So he has not to rely on old experiences and old thoughts. He has to reconstruct them. He has solved different types of complex problems in his life. Another important aim of education is to enable the pupil from such an outlook about life as can help to tackle successfully the different problems of his life in future. So he has to prepare himself for solving the problems of future also, not of present only. They have to learn to solve the problems of life in future too. To make all-round development of people, all-round development of the individual is important aim of all-time education, all types of lesson. The stresses are emphasizes on the all-round development of the students physically, mentally, socially and aesthetically. So this will develop their holistic personality. Curriculum in pragmatism. So we come to know what are the curriculum, what are the subjects, what curriculum is based on what principles. So curriculum is reflects the aims of education. Whatever the aims of education is, of aims of education of any nation depends upon the philosophy of that nation. So curriculum reflects the aims of education and thereby the philosophy of the that nation. So curriculum will be framed on the basis of certain basic principles. So pragmatism principles. So since it is based on experiment and activity, so first of all its principle is activity-based principle, which is that a curriculum should be activity-based, where student can do activity and learn from his own perception, learn from his own action. Principle of utility, that means the curriculum should be useful for future life, so not only for present life but also for future life. Principle of child-centeredness, curriculum should be child-centered. So that student take interest in it. The principle of experience, which means that learning from senses and from own perceptions. So I have taken all these things from Google. So I have written courtesy Google. Principle of integration, which integrates the child's activity and needs on one hand and the needs of present democracy on the other hand. So it integrates both the country and the child. So it aims to develop the child along with the development of democracy or nation on the other. Principle of flexibility. So this here also one type where it is. So it is principle of flexibility. We say that curriculum should not be rigid. It should be or fixed. It should be flexible, which can change according to the need or time or time and needs of students. According to pragmatism, learning must be based on child's experience as well as occupations and activities. Besides school subjects, purpose and socialized activities should be also included in curriculum. The subjects included in pragmatic curriculum are language, hygiene, history, geography, physics, mathematics, science, domestic science for girls, agriculture for boys, psychology and sociology. So all these subjects are included in the curriculum for all-round development of the students. Okay? That pragmatist view students as a whole organism constantly interacting with the environment. So students, your old people are constantly interacting with the students. The school is both a part of environment, man-made environment and nature's environment. So provide this for teachers. School has to provide to this possible educative experience to the learner. For this reason, student is especially involved in interaction with the school. The whole organism, which is child, consists of the biological child. Whole organism consists of the child as a biological child. So child is what? Child's speciality are first that he is biological child. Then his mental, since he thinks and he has reasoning powers of psychological child and he is in the society, so he is a social child. Biological by birth, psychological by mind and emotions and social child, because after birth he enters into the society, the family, then school. So as a social child he has to interact with many persons. So that experiencing organism is the learner. Brings to school with him all the meanings, so he comes to school with values, meanings and experiences that constitute his personality. So his sense is made with the values and experiences of the life. So a man is made by his values and experiences. Now the role of teacher or concept of teacher. So the role of the teacher is important in successfully educating the children. The teacher must capture the child's interest. Teacher must capture the child's interest and build on the natural motivation that exists. Teacher needs to remember to vary their teaching methods. Teachers should vary the teaching methods to accommodate each individual learning style. Because we know that all children are not of same capacity, same mental power, same emotional power, same physical capacity. So there is an individual difference. So teacher should take the individual difference in consideration and teach the children accordingly. Not all children learn at the same pace and follow at the same point. Therefore, teacher must vary his or her style depending upon the child. Do we believe that knowledge should be organized and relate to current experience? The teaching for the pragmatist is a member of learning group who serves that capacity. Teacher's role is as a helper, guide. Teacher is helper, teacher is guide, and teacher is arranger. Arranger of experience. So, teacher, arranger of experience of students. Okay. So, teacher is helper, guide, and arranger of experience. experience. Teacher is involved in educative purpose as are being student and either coming up. Teachers, sometimes teachers say according to me, we say that teachers sometimes support themselves as progressive educators and they think themselves like giving a bad report accounts like philosophers like them and confusion of the concept of freedom. So they take the child where child-centered education, where the child has given freedom to what they like. So learning by children's interest, all the children should be allowed to learn whatever they want. It is wrong. Pragmatists say that it has not to be done because children, when they are very small, they are immature, so they should not be left free to do whatever they want. So child-centered education does not mean that child are left free to do whatever they want. So teachers should help the child arrange for their learning and help arrange and care for them. So a pragmatic teacher does not forgo his responsibility. Teacher is responsible for wiring with the students and helping them to develop their own projects. Teacher guides them, teacher gives them projects and helps them to carry out their projects. He guides them, he advises, he directs the project and the activities that allow ease out of needs of the students. Whenever the students need the help of teacher, teacher must help them. He must arrange conditions. As D.V. says, simplifying, purifying, ordering, balancing the environment. Teachers should simplify the environment, purify the environment and balance the environment so that children will experience and contribute and children will experience the cooperation or children will take help of the teacher and grow. So teachers should help in growing of students, growth of the students by guiding them, by simplifying their pragmatism and curriculum. So curriculum, so we have studied, again we are discussing the intelligence of ability. What is good subject in pragmatism? Only good subjects, activities and experiences are included in the curriculum which are useful for present needs of the child and future. So you must understand present and future needs. To fulfill the present and future needs of child, the subjects are included in the curriculum are language, what these subjects will help to fulfill the present and future needs of the student. Language, physical well-being, physical training, geography, history, social things, science, agriculture and home life for girls. So we have seen ideas also. As we discussed, according to this principle, only two activities of experience were included in each generate interest. So, interest in two varieties of interest, interest in representation. Interest position is constant in the relations of activities, interest, interest, simplicity, university, and it's not the in which we can start. Interest in the relation is not to create something new, so it is always in the new. So, we can write this of interest to that stage, curriculum include writing. Writing is because it included writing, counting, art, grammar, material science, and other practical things. In practice, like writing, practical science, and working. Being a library, you want to work.
நீங்க கண்டிப்பா ரைட்டிங் ஆர்ட் இன்டரஸ்டா டீச்சர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் சொல்லி நெக்ஸ்ட் principle of experience, principle of curricular activity, occasion or experience should be closely related to the students, specifically all occasion activities and the activities become important to create in the field of education and use to the type of education and independence and independence in work operation in the field of education activity. So that is one construct, flexible, dynamic and integrated curriculum is the element of the study. Sufficient such that child and self keep both develop the mechanism and the same fragment of the focus by which other relationships. So they need social capability and media.
Now we study teaching methodology. So the most common method employed by pragmatists is the project method. Project method, in project method, teacher gives the project, he supports, guides and helps the children while doing their project. Classroom discussion is also a teaching method. And it is in a free and open atmosphere is encouraged, as well as individual problem solving research is also encouraged. All these may well involve tremendous amount of reading, studying traditional subject matter mostly. The method of educating are unique to each individual. So it
pragmatism
considers individual difference and takes care of individual difference of the students and adopts the method according to need and requirement of each individual. This philosophy believes that not all children learn in the same way, so it is important to vary educational methods. So this philosophy supports large plain text, small desk,
and hence that move easily. Classroom is a would be a functional atmosphere with the interest of the children at hand. Problem solving, themes, experiments are the parts of pragmatic philosophy or teaching method. Curriculum for pragmatic philosophy supports the connection between knowledge and experience. First, teacher initiate the activity. Then, teacher plans how to carry the activity forward. Then, to execute the plan. Then, to evaluate the progress. So, project is given and the teacher says how the project will be carried, then how it will be executed, and when it is executed, then how to evaluate the progress and the result. While all this going forward, the teacher will also encourage the learners to think up and note suggestions and new ideas for further work. So they have to write suggestions or new ideas also. They have to note, help them to formulate these suggestions both for clarification of thinking and later recall possible use. So teachers say them to write in a notebook or board for future reference. So whatever experience they earn during the project, they have to note. So students to note down them and use in future. They help pupils to criticize their thinking and root at the clues or make meanwhile. So students also criticize their work also. They do critical evaluation of their work and look back over the whole process to pick up and fix important kinds of learning. So they whatever they do, they look back and whole process and fix the important kinds of learning as well as draw lessons for the future. What they have done, they have done mistakes while doing the project. So they will mention that, they will recognize that, and they will take care of that in future work for success. So this is all about pragmatism. So pragmatism is the practical method in which students are given more importance and they do themselves, and teacher is a helper, organizer and supporter, and helps the students, and students learn from their mistakes also, and they take care of their mistakes in future plans. So this is all about pragmatism. Thank you.